Green lights and we go racing then. Good start from Vince Bristow. Great start from John Cross from pole position in the Lazio Stratos. He leads the field down towards the first corner. Ray Morgan is on the inside of Vince Bristow for third position into the first series of corners. They go on Chesson's Drift. Vince Bristow's out wide. Ray Morgan is up the inside and through into third place. But it's John Cross then from Barry Stewart in the 166 Porsche from Ray Morgan. Then Vince Bristow is the man who's having to look in his mirrors now. He's having to try and defend, as we can see. They come up the top of Harry Hill. On the defensive goes John Cross as Barry Stewart tries to find his way through. They're all wiggling and squirming and sliding all over the place, trying to find traction, trying to get those cars nailed down and through the first series of corners. But a great start there from John Cross. He leads the way towards the end of lap one.
Thought the Porsche Barry Stewart might get the best getaway, but it was John Cross from pole position, got the best launch, leads them down into Chesson's. And Ray Morgan is really showing well in the final. He missed the semi-finals and final yesterday on Saturday, thinking he had enough time to change the gearbox, ran out of minutes, unable to take the start. He's trying to make up for lost ground today by getting out in the BDA Escort as the leaders begin to close up with Barry Stewart in the Stratos, tail happy coming out of the elbow.
Barry Stewart then really trying to close up onto the back of the Lazio Stratos. Then Ray Morgan in third position in the 114. Great to see him going so well. We've been used to seeing Ray battling with Vince Bristow, but he seems to have made a bit of a step forward in terms of his pace as flame spits from the back of the Lazio Stratos coming through. Paddock Bend then, brilliant to see these cars at maximum attack, and great to see these drivers handling the Linden Hill circuit so well. Dust has been a real issue. The track was watered fairly recently, so it's not too much of a problem for our drivers, but bumpiness and ruts and so on in these retro cars are very prominent indeed, so keep an eye out for that, especially as they come through the final series of corners. But it's still John Cross who leads the way, but Ray Morgan there in third place, he's got a grandstand view of this, and if anything, I'd say he's closing up onto the back of Barry Stewart here.
Yeah, getting ever further clear of Vince Bristow. The two of them usually locked together, but it looks like Vince Bristow may have missed a gear on the first lap coming out of Chesson's Drift, and that has allowed his fellow Hastings Briston Ray Morgan just to start to concentrate on the two sports cars ahead of him. We have yellow flags at Paddock, where Pasco in the 175 Ford Escort has gone off onto the race circuit out of harm's way, but yellow flags do fly as Ray Morgan continues to stick with the top two. So this race isn't over, but we're on lap four of five, so he's running out of time if he wants to do anything about these two little sports cars ahead of him.
Well, those yellow flags in the final corner take away an overtaking opportunity, and of course with there being no joker lap in these retro races, that does mean that it's going to be a couple of opportunities, for example into Chesson's or maybe up the top of Harry Hill, for these drivers to find their way through on the penultimate lap. Though, as Dan said though, these drivers are going to be running out of opportunities before too long, so let's see what is going to happen as they come out of the north bend, down Harry Hill, in towards Paddock Bend, where that yellow flag zone is. It has now been removed, however, because the 175 Escort is out of harm's way there, fortunately for Pasco and for everybody else. So that does give another overtaking opportunity back, but we're on the final lap here and those opportunities are going to be running out.
Very good last lap from Ray Morgan to close up on the Porsche of Barry Stewart on the run into Chesson's. The top three just been very static. This gap really hasn't changed much for the last few laps. Barry Stewart thinking though, he has to go defensive into the Devil's Elbow, so he's well aware that plain white Ford Escort of Ray Morgan is in his mirrors, but Ray's only got half a lap left and he's only got a few corners to try and throw anything at the 166 Porsche.
He needs Barry Stewart to make a mistake really, coming down the hill and into Paddock Bend, but I don't think that Ray is going to be able to find his way past. But no such problem for John Cross behind the wheel of the number 99 through Paddock Bend and over the timing line. It is to take the win in the retro final for round two of the British Rallycross Championship here at Linden Hill. Fantastic driving from John Cross to claim the chequered flag in his 50th year of competition behind the wheel of the Lazio Stratos.